Him.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Like David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. We are so excited to be here, to worship in spirit and in truth, and to just serve a God who is able. He was able 2,000 years ago, and he is able today. And so we are just so excited. Can we stand and go before the Lord in prayer this morning? Dear Lord, I come to you in the name of Jesus. Just thank you for this day. I thank you for bringing us here. I thank you for just giving us another opportunity to worship you. Father God, I pray that as we sing, I pray that our melodies, I pray that the lyrics, I pray that the music is just acceptable unto you. I pray that it's a sweet aroma to you, Lord. And we just give you the praise, the worship in Jesus' name. Everybody said amen.
Amen.
Y'all put your hands together.
Declare and lift you high.
Christ revealed, and I am.
Let's go. Say,
God is fighting for us, pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. In the name of Jesus, the enemy's defeated, and we will shout it out.
Sing it again. Say, God is.
God is fighting for us, pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. In the name of Jesus, the enemy's defeated, and we will shout it out,
hallelujah, Jesus,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, Lord. Anybody know that joy is coming this morning?
Yes.
Woo! Sing, we will not be shaken. Say,
we will not be shaken.
Sing, we will not be.
We will not be moved.
For the Lord is,
for
beside,
the Lord is beside us.
With him we cannot.
With him we cannot lose.
Though shadows surround us,
we will fear no evil.
We'll trust in the Lord. Let's sing.
Though the night may seem weary,
joy is coming.
Joy is coming. In the morning.
Oh, praise to
King Jesus.
Because I know joy.
Joy is coming.
Sing, we will not be shaken.
We will not be shaken.
We will not be moved.
Not be moved.
The Lord is,
beside us.
And with him we cannot lose.
And we cannot lose.
Though
the shadows
surround us, we will fear no
evil.
We'll trust in the Lord.
Trust in the Lord with our hearts and in our joy.
We will dwell forever.
Though the night may seem weary,
joy is coming.
In the morning.
All praise
to King Jesus.
Cause I know joy.
I know joy is coming.
Though the night may seem weary, joy is coming.
In the morning.
All praise to King Jesus. Cause
I know joy.
Yes, it is.
Joy is coming.
Everybody clap your hands. Everybody clap your hands. We're gonna give God a praise this morning. It's real simple. It just says, your light can drown our darkness and bring our joy to life. We won't submit to sorrow. Our joy is coming in the morning. Y'all believe that?
Yeah.
In the morning. Everybody say your light.
Your light can drown our darkness and bring our joy to light. We won't submit to sorrow.
Our joy is coming in the morning. In the morning. You can bring it real big. Say your light.
Your light can drown our darkness and bring our joy to light. We won't submit to sorrow. Our joy is coming in the morning.
Can we say?
Morning.
Though the night may seem weary.
Joy is coming. In the morning.
All praise to King Jesus.
Cause
I know joy.
Though the night may seem weary.
Joy is coming in the morning. All praise to King Jesus.
Cause I know joy is coming.
Can we sing? Let's sing. Say,
your light can drown our darkness and bring our joy.
We won't submit to sorrow.
Our joy is coming in the morning.
We know our joy.
In the morning.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Your light can drown our sorrow.
Your light can drown our sorrow.
and bring our joy. We won't submit to sorrow.
Our joy is coming in the morning.
If you know your joy is coming in the morning, let's give God praise. Sing it again. Your light can drown our sorrow.
Your light can drown our darkness
and bring our joy. We won't submit.
We won't submit to sorrow.
Our joy is coming in the morning. In the morning. In the morning. Here we go. Though the night may seem, say.
Though the night may seem weary.
Joy is coming.
Joy is coming, coming, coming in the morning.
Oh, praise to King Jesus. Cause I know joy.
I know joy is coming.
Though the night may seem, say.
Though the night may seem weary.
Joy is coming, coming, coming.
Joy is coming, coming, coming.
In the morning.
In the morning.
All praise to King.
All praise to King Jesus.
Cause I know joy.
I know joy is coming.
Joy is.
Joy is coming.
Hallelujah. Somebody give him praise this morning. Joy. Hallelujah. Anybody know that we are holding to the promise that he has for us? Hallelujah. Sing this right here.
I pray that you hear me saying I'm being patient, waiting to hear from you. Do what you said you do.
I pray
that you
hear me
saying
I'm being patient,
waiting
to hear
from
you.
Do what you said you do.
Anybody
holding to?
I am holding to the promise
that you made to me.
Lord, I still believe.
I am holding to the promise
that you made to.
I still believe
what you promised me.
Here we go to right here. It says,
I will receive it. Lord, I'm ready. Yes, I'm ready.
Everybody say, I will receive it.
I will receive it.
Say,
I will receive it.
Lord, I'm ready.
Lord, I'm ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
Sing, I will see.
I will receive it.
I will receive it.
I will receive it.
Lord, I'm ready.
Lord, I'm ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
Yes,
Using his mind, say.
It's mine.
Say.
It's mine.
It's mine.
It's mine.
I will receive it.
I will receive it.
Lord, I'm ready.
Lord, I'm ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
It's mine.
It's mine.
It's mine.
It's mine.
Mine,
I will receive it.
Lord, I'm ready.
Lord, I'm ready.
Also ready.
Also ready.
See, it's mine. It's mine.
It's mine.
It's mine.
It's mine.
It's mine.
I will
receive it. Lord, I'm ready.
Lord, I'm ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
Lord, I'm ready.
Lord, I'm ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
Lord, I'm ready.
Lord, I'm ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
I'm holding.
Yes,
I'm say, ready. I'm holding to the promise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Anybody holding on to the promise?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Hallelujah. 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 Yeah. Come on. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yes. Come on, if you're holding on to the promises of God this morning. If you're holding on to the promises of God. Hallelujah. If you're holding on to the promises of God, I will receive it. Come on, say that to yourself.
I will receive it.
Come on, say that to yourself.
I will receive it.
Lord, I'm ready. Hey.
Yes, I'm ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
I will receive it.
Hallelujah.
I will receive it.
Hallelujah. Come on, say that.
I will receive it.
Lord, I'm ready.
Lord, I'm ready.
Hey, if you decree that on this morning, it's mine. Hey, it's mine. It's mine. It's mine. It's mine. It's mine. Hallelujah. Somebody say it's mine on this morning. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody decree that. Hallelujah.
It's mine. It's mine. It's mine. It's mine. I will receive it.
If you know you're going to receive it this morning, declare that over your life. Declare that over your family.
It's mine. It's mine. It's mine. It's mine. I will receive it.
How many made up in your mind this morning that you're going to receive what you're believing God for? The Bible tells us, hallelujah, whatever you ask for in my name, I will do it. If you go before the Lord and believe by faith, and if it's according to his will, you are going to receive it. You got to say, I will receive it. Just walk around your house.
I will receive it.
Walk around your apartment.
I will receive it.
Walk around your job.
Lord, I'm ready. Yes, I'm ready.
Come on, if you're ready, come on and lift
I
your hands.
I will receive it.
If you're ready this morning, lift your hands.
I will receive it.
If you're ready this morning, lift your hands.
I will receive it.
Hey.
Lord, I'm ready. Yes, I'm ready.
I will receive it. Hallelujah. You got to believe that.
I will receive it.
Just like Abraham at 99 years old.
I will receive it.
I'm still going to receive it.
Lord, I'm ready. Yes, I'm ready.
Hallelujah.
I will receive it.
I will receive it.
I will receive it.
Just because it's delayed doesn't mean it's denied.
I will receive it.
You got to believe by faith that you're going to receive it.
Lord, I'm ready. Lord, I'm ready.
Hallelujah. You know how you stay ready? You stay ready by being in a posture of praise. You stay ready by being in a posture of worship. You stay ready by being in a posture of servitude. That's how you stay ready for the promises of God. Lord, I trust you. Lord, I believe you. Lord, I receive it. No matter what's in front of me, the Bible said we walk by faith and not by sight. Come on, one time.
I will receive it.
Hallelujah.
I will receive it. I will receive it. Lord, I'm ready. Yes, I'm ready.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that we are holding onto the promises of God. The Bible said weeping may endure for a moment, but joy cometh in the morning, that we're going to receive the promises of God. If you believe that this morning, give the Lord a great big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Give the Lord a great big hallelujah. Point to your neighbor and say, we will receive it. We will receive the promises of God. We will receive it. If you keep on praying, if you keep on believing, if you keep on faithing it, we will receive the promises of God. Hallelujah. We shall receive the promises of God. The promises of God are yes and amen. You got to believe that over your family. We will receive breakthrough.
Hallelujah.
We will receive healing.
Yes, yes.
We will receive deliverance.
Yes.
There will be a turnaround. There will be a shift in the atmosphere. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit is going to move in my house. We will receive it. Everybody will be on fire for the Lord. Everybody will be saved in the house. We will receive the promises of God. You got to open your mouth and decree it. That's why the Bible says life and death is in the power of the tongue. Those that keep their mouth closed receive death. But those that open their mouth receive life. If you came to receive life on this morning, somebody open your mouth and give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise. I will receive it. Hey, somebody just throw your hand up. Say, I will receive it. Hey. Oh, I feel the anointing in this place. An anointing to receive. An anointing to receive. Hallelujah. An anointing to receive. The Lord is here this morning, ready to pour out his goodness, ready to pour out his mercy, ready to pour out his loving kindness, ready to pour out his blessing. For those that open their mouth and said, I will bless the Lord at all times.
Hallelujah.
And his praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul does magnify the Lord. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. Hallelujah. Come on and lift your hand and say, I receive it.
I receive it.
Come on, somebody say, I receive it.
Receive it.
I receive miracles. I receive wonders. I receive healing. I receive deliverance. I receive breakthrough. I receive financial increase. I receive it right now. I receive a turnaround in my mind. I receive a turnaround in my house. I receive a turnaround with my children. I receive it. A turnaround in my marriage. There shall be a shift. There shall be a shift in the atmosphere. There shall be a shift in my family. I will receive it right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Everything that the Lord wants to pour out over my house, I will receive it. Because the blood is over my house. The blood is over my family. The blood is over my children. Somebody shout, I receive it. This is not a cliche. This for those that's been truly seeking the Lord. For something that's near and dear your heart, you got to open your mouth and say, I receive it on today. Everything that I've been praying for. Everything that I've been hoping for. Everything that I've been doing for, everything that I fasted for, I receive it. I receive it. I receive it. I receive it in the mighty name of Jesus. The windows of heaven, I receive it. The windows are opening over your house. The windows are opening over your life. The word of God said he will open up the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing. You won't have room enough to receive whatever blessing you've been believing God for. Go ahead and shout the name of Jesus right now.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I receive it,
Jesus.
I receive it, Jesus. I receive it right now. Everything you want to pour out over my life. Everything you want to pour out over my family. My life is not my own. I belong to you, oh God. And whatever you want to pour out over my life, I receive it right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Come on and lift your hands right now. Come on and lift your hands right now. While this atmosphere is being set in the spirit, lift your hands and magnify him. Lift your hands and glorify him right now. All those that are in the sanctuary, whether you're watching online, just lift your hands and magnify him. Lift your hands right now and magnify. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
praise you. Thank you, Jesus.
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 Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on and lift your hands.
Hallelujah.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Come on and magnify him. Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah is the highest praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah is the highest praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah is the highest praise. Lord, we love you.
Lord, we love you.
One more time, y'all. Hallelujah.
Lord, we love you.
Lord, we love you.
Lord, we love you. Lord, we love you.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Somebody give him the glory. Hallelujah. Somebody give him the glory. Somebody give him the glory on this morning. Hallelujah. Lord, we love you all today, and we thank you for your visitation. How many are happy to be in the house of the Lord? Give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise. If you're happy to be in the house of the Lord, if you're happy to be in the house of the Lord, come on and give somebody a high five right now and tell them I'm happy to be in the house of the Lord as we prepare to continue to worship him and glorify him and lift him up and magnify him. We serve a great and awesome God on today who is worthy to be praised, who is worthy to be lifted up. Come on, let's continue to lift our hands before the Lord and go before his presence as our praise team brings us another selection.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Can we just get our mind on worshiping God? No matter what you're going through, no weapon formed against you will prosper. The song is real simple, it just says.
Through the fire, through the flood, through the valley, through the mud, I won't worry, I won't fear, 'cause no weapon formed against me shall prosper.
Anybody believe no weapon formed? Can you sing with me?
Sing,
no weapon formed against me
shall prosper. Say,
shall prosper.
Can we give God some praise this morning that no weapon formed?
Yes.
I'm going to sing the verse again. It just says,
through the fire, through the flood, through the valley, through the mud, I won't worry, I won't fear.
Sing no weapon, say,
no weapon
formed against me.
Formed against me.
Sing it again, sing, no weapon, say, no weapon, say.
No weapon
formed against
shall prosper.
Shall prosper.
Can we sing no weapon against? Sing, say.
No
formed against me shall prosper.
Shall prosper.
No weapon
formed
against me.
Formed against me
shall prosper.
Shall prosper.
Can we go to the bridge right here? It's real simple. It just says, and when I think that I can't take it, I'm reminded that you won't fail. And when I think that I can't make it, I'm reminded that you are good. And when I think, say,
when I think
prosper.
Shall prosper.
Can we go back to that bridge right there? Can we sing? And when I think, and when
I think that I can't take it, I'm reminded that you won't fail.
And when I think
that
prosper.
Shall prosper.
We give you the praise, Jesus. Oh, sing no
weapon
formed against me.
Formed against me.
Shall prosper.
Shall prosper.
Can we just sing this right here? Can we sing this? It's real simple. Claim it over your life. Say, it won't work. It won't work. It won't work. It won't work. Can you sing, say?
It won't work.
Real big, come on.
It won't work.
Sing it one word.
It won't work. It won't work.
Sing it again, sing it one word.
It won't work.
It won't work.
Just stay one. There, just stay one.
Sing it again. Say,
it won't work. It won't work. It won't work.
There, just stay one.
There, just stay one.
Sing it again. Say,
it won't work. It won't work.
Sing it won't work.
It won't work.
Somebody say it won't work. We're gonna stay right there. Somebody say it won't work. It won't work against my life. It won't work against my family. It won't work against my children. It won't work against my health. It won't work. Come on, somebody needs to hear that this morning. You gotta decree that over your life. It won't work. It won't work. It won't work. It won't work. The attack against my house, it won't work. Come on, somebody. Hey, it won't work. Hallelujah. It won't work. It won't work. The attack against my health, it won't work. It won't work. It won't work. Against my mind, it won't work. Hey, 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 it won't work. Whatever you're fighting on today, it won't work. You cannot curse what God has blessed. Yeah, you can't curse what God has blessed. You're trying to come after my children, it won't work. Job.
It won't work.
The attack against my life.
It won't work. It won't work.
The attack against what God has blessed me with.
It won't work.
It won't work, church family.
It won't work.
The devil tried to kill me three times, but
it won't work.
It won't work.
It won't work.
You know why they couldn't fire you?
It won't work.
was formed, but it did not prosper.
Yes.
It hit us, but it did not prosper. It came against the house. It did not prosper. You know why? Because the blood of Jesus was on the doorpost. Somebody say, it won't work.
It won't work.
Hey.
It won't work.
It won't work, church.
It won't work. It won't work.
Hallelujah.
It won't work.
If you're watching online, it won't work.
It won't work.
If you're in the sanctuary, it won't work.
It won't work. It won't work.
It won't work, church. Hallelujah. That's why you got to walk around your house and decree that. It won't work.
Hallelujah.
It won't work. The devil might try, but it won't work. Give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise on this morning as our praise and worship team is being dismissed. Come on and lift your hands to the Lord. Hallelujah. You got to give the Lord a it won't work praise. You got to give him a it won't work dance. You got to give him a it won't work shout. It won't work. Somebody been in a battle this week, but it won't work. It won't work. It won't work.
It won't work.
Keep on fighting. You know why? Because
it won't work.
Keep on fighting.
It won't work.
Keep on fighting. You know why?
It won't work. It won't work.
Keep on believing. You know why?
It won't work.
Keep on believing. Come on, somebody.
It won't work.
Keep on believing. You know why?
Because it won't work. It won't work.
Keep on shouting. You know why?
Because it won't work. It won't work.
It won't work, church.
It won't work.
Your weapon that's formed against you won't prosper.
It won't work.
How many times have the devil tried to kill you?
It won't work. It won't work. It won't work. It won't work.
You woke up and couldn't remember anything, but it won't work.
It won't work.
Covered and protected. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible says he'll give his angels charge over you to keep you in all of your ways. The Bible said no evil shall befall you and no plague shall come near your dwelling. The weapon won't prosper. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I remember the weapon came against our family. Hallelujah. COVID-19 hit our house in 2021, at the end of 2021. And three of us was in the hospital. But it just won't work. It just won't work. Hallelujah. Three of us was in the hospital. Hallelujah. Two of us on the same day rushed to the hospital. Me and my daughter. Then my wife, all of us left in the ambulance. It just won't work. It just won't work. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. None of us could breathe on our own. It just won't work. It just won't work. and mine went into complete respiratory failure. But
it just won't work. It just won't work.
Hey, hallelujah. The next step will ICU.
It just won't work. It just won't work.
Hallelujah. The weapon that's formed against you will not prosper.
It just won't work. It just won't work.
God, restore.
No weapon.
Hallelujah.
Formed against me shall prosper.
Sometimes you might got to go through a job experience, but guess what?
No weapon formed against me shall prosper.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. No weapon. We prepare for the word of God, Father God, in Jesus' name, as we come before your presence on this morning, oh God. Lord, we just thank you for your visitation, oh God. Lord, rest upon every person in every seat, every aisle right now. May the Holy Spirit flow through and out this church right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father God, may your presence overwhelm us, Lord, and may you speak to us through your word. We understand that faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. Lord, uproot anything that will come against our hearing and listening to the word of God, oh God, and applying it. Father God, we thank you for a mighty move on today. Lord, send a word that would destroy every yoke. Send a word right now that would break chains. We thank you in advance, Lord, for what you're going to do. And we give you the praise, the honor, and the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise as we're preparing for the word of God. While you're standing there, go ahead, give somebody a high five, shake somebody. Go ahead and just touch on somebody and love somebody this morning. Tell somebody good morning. Hallelujah. Just go across to your neighbor and tell them good morning. It's great to see all of you in the house of the Lord on today. We serve a great and mighty God. Go ahead and greet somebody. Go ahead and greet somebody on this morning. Go ahead and greet somebody in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We give God the glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you. He's worthy to be praised. How many that know that joy is coming in the morning? Hallelujah. We certainly thank our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ on this morning. He is worthy to be praised and worthy to be lifted up and worthy to be glorified. Hallelujah. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the only wise God. We're certainly grateful for him on today. Somebody give the Lord a great big hallelujah praise on today. Hallelujah. One more time. Give the Lord a great big hallelujah praise. It's a celebration. Every time we come into the house of the Lord, amen, it's great to see all of your smiling faces on today. And as we're preparing for the word of God, amen, God is good and he is worthy, amen, to be praised, amen, hallelujah. How many know the Bible said you will hear of wars and rumors of wars? And we know there is in maybe a possible war going on over in Israel with Iran attacking Israel. But the Bible tells us to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Amen. It didn't say who's right or wrong. It just said pray for the peace of Jerusalem, because that's where Jesus is going to set up his throne when he returns. Amen. So we want to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Hallelujah. The Bible said those that pray for the peace of Jerusalem shall prosper. So we want to pray that there would be peace in Jerusalem. Hallelujah. That God would bring forth order in the Middle East. Amen. And he protect all the innocent people that are involved too as well. Amen. So we're praying for the peace of Jerusalem, as the Bible tells us in Psalm 122, to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Amen. We're going to be in the book of Colossians on today, chapter 3. The book of Colossians, chapter 3, verse 1. I'll be reading from the New King James Version. If you need a physical Bible, if you're in the house of the Lord, just raise your hand. Amen. We greet all of you that are watching virtually with us online. Do us a great big favor right now and share this broadcast to help us spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. We thank you so much for tuning in on today. And we greet you in the mighty and precious name of Jesus Christ. Colossians chapter 3. Amen. Colossians chapter 3. We're going to read verses 1, amen, through 10. Hallelujah. Colossians chapter 3, verses 1 through 10. And I'll be reading from the New King James Version. Amen. Colossians chapter 3, starting at verse 1, it says, "If then you were raised with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ is, sitting at the right hand of God." Verse 2 says, "Set your minds on things above, not on things of the earth." Verse 3 said, "For you died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God." Verse 4 said, "When Christ, who is our life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory." Verse 5 says, "Therefore put to death your members which are on the earth: fornication, uncleanness, passion, evil desire, and covetousness, which is idolatry." Verse 6 says, "Because of these things, the wrath of God is coming upon the sons of disobedience." Verse 7 said, "In which you yourself once walked when you lived in them, but now you yourselves are to put off all of these: anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy language out of your mouth." Verse 9 said, "Do not lie to one another, since you have put off the old man with his deeds." Verse 10 said, "And have put on the new man, who is renewed in knowledge according to the image of him who created him." The message on this morning is, put on the new man. Put on the new man. Amen. You may have your seats in the very presence of God. Put on the new man. Hallelujah. We certainly thank God for our musicians on today and setting the atmosphere. Hallelujah. Put on the new man. And when I'm saying the new man, not in the sense of male and female or ontologically, but talking about putting on the new creation or the new person in Christ. Hallelujah. How many know the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 5 and 17, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a what? New creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new." So we have to make sure that we put on the new man each and every day. God wants us to walk in the spirit and not the flesh. Remember on last week, the message is the resurrection power is in you. So we're still standing on that theme that, you know, 2 weeks after Easter, we have to realize that the resurrection was not an event. The resurrection is a person, and that person is Jesus Christ. And we are to live resurrected lives now. So the thing for us as believers, how do we apply the resurrection to our lives going forth now? You know, how does it manifest in our life? And that manifests by putting on the new man that we have been created to be in Christ. Because walking in the flesh is carnality. We learned that on last week. Walking in the flesh is carnality. Somebody said carnality. Carnality is a life consumed by satisfying fleshly desires, constantly feeding selfishness, and indulging in the flesh with its ungodly appetites and passions. You know, that's walking in carnality. But the resurrected man walks in the spirit. Somebody say walk in the spirit. Okay, so we learned last week, if the same spirit that raised Jesus Christ from the dead lives in us, then we're empowered to live the life that God has placed us here on the earth to fulfill. It's just up to us that we have to tap into what's down inside of us. Somebody say amen. Somebody say tap into that resurrection power. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. Is Jesus in the grave? Uh-huh. So why are we in the grave? We'd have no reason to be in the grave if Jesus not in the grave. Where is he at? At the right hand of God, forever living to make intercession for us. Hallelujah. Glory to God. If Jesus stayed in the grave only 3 days, that means our grave and our tomb should only be temporary. Somebody said temporary. Whatever you're dealing with should only be temporary. Don't make things that you're dealing with a lifetime sentence. Okay? Don't make it a lifetime sentence. Somebody say temporary. It's not meant for us to dwell there, but to learn from it and resurrect from it. Somebody say amen. We are to learn from it and resurrect from it. Remember, our position is raised up. Somebody say raised up. Our position is resurrection. I don't care what you're going through right now. Your position is risen in Christ. Somebody say risen in Christ. Ephesians 2 and 6 says, and God raised us up with Christ and seated us with him in heavenly places. So our position is always up. We're seated with Christ because we're in Christ. How many know we are citizens of heaven? We're in a foreign land here on earth, but we're citizens of heaven. And so our position is always seated with Christ. Somebody say amen. And that's what verse 1 is saying here. If you look at the book of Colossians, verse 1, and this is written by the Apostle Paul, and the Apostle Paul was encouraging the Colossian church to not walk in carnality, but to walk in the new man in Christ. If you look at verse 1, it says, if then you were raised with Christ, seek those things which are above where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. The Bible said, if then you were raised with Christ. Somebody said, raised with Christ. Raised means to raise together, to rise together. Meaning that if we're risen with Christ, we need to seek those things above where Christ is. Somebody say, amen. Uh-huh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Since we got up with Christ, then our look should be upward to him. Somebody say, amen. His crucifixion was our crucifixion. His resurrection was our resurrection. So now since we're raised with Christ, no longer are we in darkness. No longer are we in destruction. No longer are we in death or hopeless or in the tomb. We are raised with Christ. Somebody say amen. Our focus now needs to be on living the new life in Christ. That's what the resurrection was all about. The resurrection was not about one event. The resurrection was about believers using the same power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead that's in them to live the life that God has called us to, a resurrected, empowered life. Somebody say amen. Yeah, so the Bible says if you then were raised with Christ, somebody say, I'm raised with Christ. You remember Mickey Howard in the 80s had that song, Love Under New Management, back in like around 1989. I'm in love under new what? Management. And that's what we say, I'm under new management now. I'm under the management of Christ now. I'm not under the management of the devil now. Somebody say amen. Somebody say, I found somebody that loves me and walks with me and talks with me and cares about me and doesn't use me. Somebody give God the glory right now. I find somebody that wants to best for me. Somebody say amen. Who guides me and leads me and corrects me when I'm out of line, because we are raised with Christ now and we are under new management. Somebody say amen. Uh-huh. Yeah, 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 yeah. That new management, I'm under Jesus Christ, who loved me and died for me and wants the best for me. Somebody say amen. Who forgave us of our sins and freed us from the power of sin. Somebody say, I'm raised with Christ now. I'm raised with Christ now. How many know we were raised from a life of death and destruction to a life of peace and hopes? Hallelujah. Somebody say, raised with Christ. See, that's what you got to know on this morning. You and I are raised with Christ. We don't walk around with our heads down. We don't walk around wondering if we're going to come out. We don't walk around in sadness. We walk around knowing that we're raised with Christ, and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is seated at the right hand of God, forever living to make intercession for us. So we don't wander around in hopelessness. We don't wander around in sadness. We don't wander around with our heads down like we're going to make it. Baby, we know we're going to make it because we're raised with Christ. I wish somebody would give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise if you know that you are raised with Christ on this morning. Somebody say, I'm raised with Christ. I'm raised with Christ. That's why you couldn't give up, because you're raised with Christ. Anybody ever tried to throw in a towel, but you're raised with Christ? You couldn't stay down because you're raised with Christ. Somebody say amen. You couldn't stay in the pit. You know why? Because you're raised with Christ. Resurrection power don't allow you to stay down. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise because you're raised with Christ. That's why we don't stay in the tomb of depression. We're raised with Christ. We all go through some things in life, but you don't have to stay there. You don't have to live there. You don't have to dwell there. Somebody said, I'm up with Christ on this morning. Somebody said, I'm raised with Christ. If then you were raised with Christ, seek those things that are above. Somebody said, raised with Christ. And if you're raised with Christ, you got to say to yourself, self, get up from that sadness. Somebody say amen. Self, get up from that weakness. Somebody say, self, get up from that bondage. Somebody say, self, get up from that addiction. Self, get up from that self-centeredness, baby. I'm raised with Christ, and I don't have to spend another day in this bondage. Somebody say amen. You say, sickness, I'm raised with Christ. Because his word says, by his stripes, I am healed. Yeah, that's my state that I'm in, a healed state. Because the Bible said by his stripes, I don't care what you're dealing with. I don't care what the report said. I'm telling you right now, his word overrides the fact. Somebody say amen. My position is healed because the Bible said by his stripes, his blood, I am healed. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise. We don't sit around in pity parties. All about, we don't just sit around in that. We come out of that. Somebody say amen. Yeah. That's why David says, why my soul so disquieted within me? He said, hope thou in God. We got to get our minds back on the Lord, who we're raised with. Somebody say amen. Somebody say, I'm raised with Christ. If you raised with Christ, then everything connected to you is raised. Somebody say amen. If you are raised with Christ, everything connected to you is right. I don't care what's going on with your sister right now. You got to say, if they connected with me, they are raised with Christ. Somebody say amen. That's the position. My children are raised with Christ in spite of what they may be doing. In spite of what may be going on in your house. You are raised with Christ. Somebody say amen. Somebody say, I'm raised with Christ. If you raised with Christ, baby, your health is raised with Christ. Your mind is raised with Christ. Your marriage is raised with Christ. Your children are raised with Christ. Your family is raised with Christ. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise that I'm raised with Christ. Somebody say, I'm raised with Christ. It said, if you raised with Christ, seek those things which are, verse 1, above where Christ is. So it said our minds and our appetites and our desires should be seeking those things that are above where Christ is. The Bible tells us, where is he at? Seated at the right hand of God. And it said we need to seek those things which are above. That means our appetites should be for heavenly things. Somebody say amen. Yeah. That means your desire, your cravings, the things that you seek should be the things above. Somebody say amen. Somebody say, we need to have an appetite for heavenly things. Like making sure the gospel is preached. Like making sure we witness. Yeah. Like focusing on having peace and joy. And love in our life, and walking with patience, and having self-control. Seek those things that are what? Above. Like faith, like mercy, like goodness, like compassion. Like the word of God, and walking in humility. Seek those things which are above.
like walking in obedience and righteousness and holiness, the things that the world wants to get the church away from. Somebody say amen. Seek those things which are above. The Bible said we are not of this world. And if we're not of this world, that means our minds need to be focused on the things that are above. Somebody say amen. Like seeking the kingdom of God and not just an earthly platform. Somebody say amen. Like focusing on the second coming of Christ. Somebody say amen. Focusing on things that please God and not just please our flesh. Somebody say amen. Seek the things that are what? Above where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Verse 2 says, set your mind. Somebody say, set your mind. On things what? Above. Not on the things on the what? The earth. Whoa, the earth. Yeah, this is a temporary place. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the temporary place. The Bible says about the heaven and the earth, they're going to disappear, but the word of God stands forever. Yes, we need to set our minds on the things above, not on the things on the earth. Remember last week I gave you that illustration, how the old school TV, you had to go up and turn that channel. Like you set it to channel 3 and they ain't going to move unless you get back up and turn it. Ain't with no remote, you got to get up and turn the channel. Well, that's how our minds need to be set on the things that are above. Whatever channel you set it on back in the day, that's what that TV stayed on till you got up and changed the channel. Somebody say amen. So when it says set your mind, that means put your mind in a position on the things above. That means set it. Make sure your mind is fixed on certain things. Somebody say amen. There is always a battle for the mind. And remember I said this last week, whatever dominates the mind wins. Somebody say amen. Yeah, you can come to church every Sunday, but whatever is dominating your mind throughout the week is what is winning. Somebody say amen. That's what you got to evaluate. Don't evaluate it by your Sunday attendance. Evaluate it Monday through Saturday and see what is dominating your mind, what's dominating your eye gates, what's dominating your life, and you will know who's winning. That's why I say set your mind on the things above. All of us can look good for 2 hours on Sunday, but how are we Monday through Saturday? What are our minds set on? What are our minds dominate on? What are we doing for the kingdom of God? Somebody say amen. Yeah. That's why I set your mind on the things, what? Above. Too many people got their mind set on what they want, what pleases them. How I'm going to get to this and that and that next level. The Bible said we need to set our minds on the things above and not on the things on the earth. Our minds need to be filled with the things above. Somebody say amen. Like salvation. Yeah, the Bible said, what does it profit a man to gain the world and lose his soul? We can get everything on the earth, but if you die without Jesus, you're eternally lost and your family members. Set your mind on the things above. The most important thing at Thanksgiving is not the food. It's all your family saved. Yeah, set your mind on the things above. So when you're thinking 3 months out for the dinner, you need to be thinking how you're going to witness. Somebody say amen. Yeah. Set your mind on the things above. Because we need to be focused on things like salvation. Like kindness, like compassion, like healing, like people getting breakthrough, walking in unity. Somebody say amen. Being a witness, serving God, giving to others, helping the poor, carrying out our purpose, being praiseworthy, lifting up Jesus, glorifying God, setting our minds on the things that are what? Above. Because the things on the earth lead to destruction. Like lust, like pride, like sexual perversion, like drunkenness, like witchcraft, like gossip, like manipulation, like anger, like greed, like wrath. Those things lead to destruction. But the things above, God said, will lead to the abundant life. The things above will lead to you living out of faith life. The things above will lead to you being powered by a word life. The things above will allow you to live a Holy Spirit-led life. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise if you're focusing on seeking the things that are above. Verse 3 says, for you died. Somebody said, you died. and your life is hidden with Christ in God. You died. You know what that means? That means the old man died. You know, the message is put on the new man. You died, meaning the old, sinful, corrupt man died when you gave your life to Jesus. Yeah, the lying you, the perverted you, the drunk you, the murderer you, the broken you, the always angry you, say it should have died when we gave our life to Jesus. Somebody say amen. You die is past tense. Somebody say amen. Because now we're dead to sin, but alive in what? Christ. Our old life has been crucified with Christ. And now our new life is hidden in Christ. Somebody say amen. Our old life has been buried by the blood of Jesus. Somebody say amen. Somebody say you died. And your life is hidden with Christ in God. So if you die, that means that old life needs to be what? Over. Somebody say over. Yeah. No longer will your past hurt you. No longer will your past hinder you. No longer will your past control you because you died. Somebody say you died. A dead person don't respond to nothing. Somebody say amen. Yeah. A dead person don't respond to nothing. So when it means you died, that means I don't respond to the things of the world anymore like I used to respond to it. Somebody said I'm dead to it. Somebody say amen. I'm dead to the vices. I'm dead to the old temptations. I'm dead of the things that's trying to trap me. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise and know that you died this morning. The old you is dead, baby. God has a new you on the horizon now. He raised you up for such a time as this for you to walk in your greatness, to walk in your season, to walk in the new man in Christ. Somebody said, I'm raised up with Christ for such a time as this. Everybody was born for the time they was needed to most. And right now, everybody in here and watching online, if you gave your life to Christ, you are a new creature in Christ. And now it's time for us to know that we died to the old man. And it's time for us to walk in victory, baby, to walk with our heads up, to walk and know that God is on our side, because the Bible said, if God be for you, who can be against you? No longer are we hopeless, we're hopeful. Because our lives are hidden in Christ now. The old you is covered by the blood of Jesus. Now we're protected under his wings. Somebody say amen. For you died and your life is hidden with Christ in God. Yeah, you died, the old you. Now we're hidden in Christ. No longer are we controlled by our past, but we should be now focused on our future and what God is doing in our life. Too many people stuck on the old them. Where God said, I want to see the new you come forth. Lazarus, come forth, the new you. Yeah, God said, I want to see the resurrected you come forth now. Yeah, you got that power. I want to see the resurrected you come forth. How many made up in your mind that the resurrected me is coming forth? Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise that the resurrected me is turned loose now in 2024, that I will go forth and do what God has called me to do. Look at verse 5. Verse 4. When Christ, who is our life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. When Christ, who is our life, appears, then you will appear with him in glory. Where is he at right now? The Bible told us in verse 1. Where is he at right now? Where is he at right now? At the right hand of God. But the Bible said when Christ, who is our life, appears. Come on, somebody. It said, then you also will appear with him in glory. Yeah, talking about that second coming of Christ. That's why the Bible said in 1 Thessalonians that those who remain alive will be caught up together with them in the clouds, and we going to meet the Lord in the air. Yeah, we going to meet the Lord in the air one day. That's why I said when Christ of our life appears, then you will also appear with him in glory. The Bible said those who remain will be caught up, and the dead in Christ is going to raise, and we going to meet the Lord in air, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. Yeah, we're going to meet the Lord in the air. Yeah, y'all remember Superman in the 80s? Yeah, we're going to be doing that for real. Yeah, no, for real. No space suit. no oxygen mask, no airplane, and no rocket booster. But the Bible says he's going to give a loud command in 1 Thessalonians. Somebody say amen. And with the sound of the archangel, baby, and everybody going to meet the Lord in the car. You ought to give the Lord a great big hand cup of pride. Baby, it's a bird, it's a plane. No, it's the believers, baby, who are in Christ Jesus that meeting the Lord in the air when he appears again. We're hidden in Christ. Now, no bird, no plane. It's the believers who are hidden in Christ. Who are hidden in Christ. Go on to meet the Lord. The Bible said when he appears, we will appear with him in glory. Read 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. Yeah, Jesus is going to give a command. We're just going to start flying. Yeah, all them airplanes in the air, we're going to pass right by them. Meet him in the clouds. No spacesuit, no oxygen mask. Just a command from his word and his voice. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's what we're waiting on. That's why the Bible said, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up on wings like eagles, baby. That day when the Lord gives a command, when he appears, we're going to be like the eagles in the sky. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise. When he appears, we will appear with him in glory. Hallelujah, because we're raised with Christ. If he can do it, we can do it. Peter saw Jesus walking on water. That's my Lord and Savior. I can do it too. Jesus in the cloud flying, we can. Come on, somebody. Give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise. That's the word, y'all. We are raised with Christ. And so we see in verse 1 through 4, the writer encouraged us, since we are raised with Christ, he said we need to set our minds on the things above. He reminds us that we died our old life and we're hidden with him in Christ. And he says one day we're going to appear with Christ. So he says all those things to say this in verse 5. He said, look, these things, the believers should not live like this. Look at verse 5. Therefore, put to death. Somebody said, put to death. Your members, which are on the earth, your members. Look at that word in the Greek, means like members of the human body, like your limbs. Your members, which are on the earth. He's going to cover five sins. Somebody said five sins. Therefore, put to death your members, which are on the earth. Fornication, uncleanness, passion, evil desires, and covetousness, which is idolatry. He said, put them to death. Somebody say amen. Four of them, the first four deal with sexual perversion. The other one, covetousness, deals with being greedy. Somebody say amen. So he said, therefore, put to death your members which are on the earth, like your eyes. The Bible said the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life are all that are in the world. So he said, put to death your members. Yeah, uh-huh, yeah. Yep, your member, like your eyes, like your hands that click the keyboard. That's in control of social media. It's your members. Feet that are quick to shed and run to evil. It's your members. your members. Your limb, your eyes. Yeah. The car didn't put you over there. You got in there with your feet. Your hands commit sin. Your mouth, your eyes. Put to death your members. It's the members that cause all the stuff that we get ourselves involved in. Somebody say amen. Uh-huh. For some of us, it could just be the click. And it's getting us in trouble because we need to put to death our members. Somebody say amen. Uh-huh. The body parts, the limb. Somebody say amen. Right, because look, the sexual organs didn't get the person over there. Their members did. Uh-huh. The members. That's why he said, put to death. Somebody said, put to death your members which are on the earth. And then he named them. Yeah. He named them. Put to death means to deprive of power. Somebody say amen. To destroy the strength. Amen. I remember, y'all remember that movie I'm trying to think of? Is it Fireproof, one of the movies, when the guy was struggling with pornography? And his wife used to come in there, and she knew what he was doing. Then one day, so you know, I'm tired, he took a bat to that computer. So I got to put to death because my members getting me in trouble. So he just destroyed the computer. so his hand wouldn't get him in no more trouble. Amen. It says, put to death your what? Members. Put to death your members. The members is what get people in trouble. People be saying, y'all young people know what they be saying today. It's going down in the DMs. So many affairs and everything, and people DMs, what got them there? The hands, the eyes, the members. The members got you in trouble. Somebody say amen. And the mind controlling the members. Set your mind on things above so your members don't get you in trouble. Somebody say amen. 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 First thing he said fornication. The word fornication here is a broad meaning because that's where we get the word. It's, in the Greek, it's porneia, where they get the word pornography. But the word fornication here is for a broad use of illicit intercourse, sexual intercourse. Adultery, fornication, homosexuality, bestiality, incest, all fall under this word fornication here. Look it up in the Greek. Anything sexually outside of Genesis 2 and 24, where God says, shall a man leave his mother and father and cleave to his wife? He said, anything outside of that falls under the fornication. Somebody say amen. Said, therefore, shall a man leave his father and mother, shall cleave to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. Anything outside of that, it falls under that first one there, fornication. Somebody say amen. Amen. And then, if you look at uncleanness, passion, evil desire, all of those are dealing with some type of form of sexual impurity, whether it be things that are lustful, misuse of sex, passion, evil desires. These are all form of sexual sin, fornication, uncleanness, passion, and evil desire. They all form of sexual sin. He said, put them to death. He said, because when we do those, we're sinning against not only the Holy Spirit and God, we're sinning against our own bodies. Somebody say amen. Even though we died with Christ, we have to kill the former patterns of behavior. Somebody say amen. If we didn't have to put it to death, he never would have mentioned it. He said, oh, you died, but you got to put to death those members. Somebody say amen. Those former patterns of behavior that'll get us in trouble. And then he mentions covetousness, which is idolatry. Covetousness is greedy. Greedy desire to have more. It's idolatry. It's worship of false gods. Because when you start thinking you're thinking more is going to fulfill your life, you slide over into covetousness. If I can just get more money, more platform, more status, more friends, more gigs, more luxury, you can easily fall over into covetousness. The pursuit of things sometimes can breed covetousness. There's nothing wrong with going after things, but when they start becoming little gods in your life, it can creep over into covetousness. When you always have that spirit, I always need more. I always need more. My neighbor got this, so I need more. I find out my friend got this, I need more. I find out somebody else doing this at church, I need more, 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 more. They got this done in their car, I got to get this done. They got this in the backyard, I got to get this. It can turn into covetousness, a greedy spirit. Somebody say amen. Jesus warned us about covetousness in Luke 12 and 15. He said, take heed, beware of covetousness, for one's life does not consist in the abundance of things he possesses. He was talking about covetousness. Be aware of it. So those five things there in verse 5, the apostle Paul said, put them to death, fornication, uncleanness, passion, evil desire, and covetousness, which is idolatry. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise that even though we're saved and raised with Christ, we got to continue to kill our flesh on a daily basis. All of us. Somebody say amen. Look at verse 6. Now, he told us to put to death, and he tells us why in verse 6. Somebody said, because of these things, the wrath of God is coming upon the sons of disobedience. Here is why we have to kill our members. These things invite the wrath of God. I ain't said the word said it. He says, because of these things, what thing? What he said in verse 5. the wrath of God is coming upon the who? Sons of what? Disobedience. Yeah, these things invite wrath in our lives. The wrath of God, his anger, his vengeance, his punishment towards those who refuse to walk in obedience, so he calls them the sons of what? Disobedience. And then, so he ends up visiting the sons of disobedience. Anybody ever been visited by God? I know I have. In a not so good way sometimes. Yeah. He visits the sons of disobedience. Those who are stubborn and in opposition to the will of God. Mm-hmm. When we have that I do what I want to do attitude, then you might get a visitation. Somebody say amen. Might get a visitation and not the one you want. Yeah. I do what I want to do attitude can get you a visitation from the wrath of God. That means his judgment. It does not mean that we're not saved. It just means that God got a way of correcting. The Bible said, who the Lord loveth, he what? Chastens. Just like you chasing your children. Say, the sons of disobedience, I got to get you back in obedience. And say, you didn't listen to my little still voice, I got to come a little bit louder. Somebody say amen. Yeah, because God said, this is not how my children act or should be acting as children of God. They should act according to my ways, my word, and my precepts. They can either listen to me or go with plan B. Somebody say amen. Plan B is the wrath. Somebody say amen. I think I'll just work on putting to death my members. Somebody give God the glory on this morning. I think I'd rather just putting to death everything that he spoke of. Somebody give God the glory on this morning. I'd rather just focus on lining up with God's will, doing what he said. I've been whooped enough. I've lost too much. I've been set back too much to still be playing games with God's word. Anybody like me this morning, you said, I've lost too much. I've wasted too much years. I've done it my way. I'm ready to do it God's way. Whatever you want me to put to death, God, give me the strength, the conviction, and the power to overcome it. I'm here as your willing servant. Somebody say amen. God, I surrender to you. That's what that maturity, that's what when you going through a lot of stuff, life have a way of like, well, Lord, whatever you want me to do. You come out of that rebellious thing. I just do what I want to do. I'm a grown and I just do this. You know, I'm just going to have me some fun, and you go through enough stuff, you'll stop talking like that. Amen. Ask me how I know. Amen. I think the better option is putting it to death. Amen. Somebody say amen. Look at verse 7. Verse 7 says, in which you yourself once walked when you lived in them. He said, look, you guys used to live like this. He said, this is your past life, but it should not be your future life. He said, and he talked to the Colossian church, in which you yourself once walked when you lived in them. He said, they used to do it habitually. But he's saying now that should not be your position now. You should be fighting to put those things to death. Somebody say amen. We're not perfect, baby, but we should be fighting. Somebody say amen. I'm here to tell you this morning that a struggle is good. People be thinking they weak because they struggling. No, baby, if I wasn't struggling, I'd just be in it, baby, putting up no fight, going to do it. If I'm struggling, I'm in a fight with my flesh, baby. If you are struggling this morning, that means you are fighting, you are pulling, you are tugging, you're trying to do the best you can. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise for your struggle, because the struggle means you're putting up a fight. Baby, if I wasn't struggling, I'd be somewhere this morning. I mean, I just do what I want to do. Struggle means a fight. When I was in the world, I just did what I wanted to do. I know struggle. I'm just going to do it. A struggle means a fight. Stop looking down on people because of their struggle. The struggle means they fighting, baby. You should have been shouting that they reduced it down from 5 instead of 30 days. It's down to 5 days. Somebody give the Lord a great big shout right now, baby. And shout right now that you're overcoming your struggles. You might not be all the way there, baby, but you're fighting a good fight of faith. Somebody give God the glory. Hallelujah. Yes, he said that some of y'all used to walk like this. Hallelujah. So he said, look, anything outside of God's will, we need to just work on killing it because God is not pleased with it. And what the Apostle Paul says, that we shouldn't get comfortable in habitual sin. That's why he's saying, in which you yourself once walked when you lived in it. So y'all used to walk in that before y'all Christ, but now that you're saved, you guys need to work on killing that And he gave the five sins that he named more than likely because that church was struggling with those things. Somebody say amen. That's why the psalmist David said in Psalm 119 and 71, this scripture really stakes out to me because the psalmist David said, it was good that I was afflicted. Who wants to be afflicted? He said it was good that I was afflicted. You know why he said that? So I wouldn't get comfortable in it. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise. David said it was good that I was afflicted. I've been like David before, so you won't get comfortable in it. Hallelujah. So it won't abort your assignment. So it won't destroy your life. I'm here to tell you, you don't want to get comfortable in something so you won't, somebody won't die and go to hell. You don't never want to be comfortable in something. Somebody say amen. That's why David said, it was good that I was afflicted. God whooped me so good it got my life lined up with him. Somebody say, anybody ever been there? Somebody give the Lord a great big hand. I'm afraid. David said, creating me a clean heart and renewing me a right spirit. David said, when I was hiding in my sin, my bones was waxing away. But when I repented and got back in right standing with God, he didn't take his anointing nor his position away. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand. Clap of praise. Hallelujah. It was good that I was afflicted. Look at verse 8. Now, remember, he talked about the five first sins in verse 5. Now he's going to deal with another five sins in verse 8 that deals with how we relate and communicate and speak to other people. So he told them to kill certain things in verse 5. Then he's going to tell them to put off certain things in verse 8. Verse 8 says, but now, somebody said, but now. You yourselves are to put off these. Somebody said, put off these. He's given the analogy, put off is like with soiled clothes. Somebody said, soiled clothes. Like, say if you've been at the gym for an hour and a half doing cardio. By the time you leave, you do that much cardio, you know you're going to be what? Sweat up a storm. You're probably going to be soaked after an hour and a half doing straight cardio. You go home and take a shower. You get out the shower, lotion up, do that. You don't put back on the same soiled clothes. You grab new clothes. Because if you put back on the same soiled clothes, even though you wash yourself, the soiled clothes going to contaminate you. So it overshadows what you've already doing by taking a shower because you put back on the same sweaty clothes. So he says, put off. Because those clothes don't fit you now as a new creation in Christ. Somebody say amen. So some people think they can still have the same lips like they were in the world speaking certain things. He said, that don't fit you now. Somebody say amen. So he gives the analogy of soiled clothes. Five things he names. He said, but now you yourself put off these. Anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy language out of your mouth. Somebody say amen. Those five sins. Those are dealing with how you relate to others and how you speak to others. Anger is dealing with a temper, having a temper all the time. That's different, though, than having righteous anger. When you're angry, somebody did somebody wrong. That's different. But if somebody just having a temper all the time, that shows the character issues. Somebody say amen. Where your mind is set on anger daily. He said, put that off. Put that off. Then he says, wrath. Wrath is fierceness. Wrath is boiling over when you're ready to blow up all the time. He said, put that off. You always set on blowing up. Just blowing up. Mm-hmm. The microwave went off. Just the microwave just beeped off. When your mind is set on wrath. That's why he says, set your mind on things above. He says, anger, wrath, he says what? Put those things off. Wrath, where you're just always about to blow up and boiling over. Malice, that's dealing with maliciousness. Ill will, where you're always looking to hurt somebody. You know that analogy, that saying, like, hurt people? And that's true sometimes. People are broken and hurt. They're looking to hurt other people. That's malice. You got an ill will towards doing stuff malicious. He said, put that off. Somebody said, put that off. Change your clothes. Somebody said, change your clothes. That's in the spirit realm. And then he says, blasphemy. Blasphemy. Most people think of blasphemy, think about blasphemy, speaking ill against the Holy Spirit. No, blasphemy here is slander, is evil speaking. It's injurious speech that can hurt someone or their good name. Blasphemy, when you're tearing somebody down. Somebody say amen. That's blasphemy. He said what? Put it off. Then he says, the last one, filthy language out of your mouth. He says what? Put it off. Foul language, obscene speech, vile conversations, cuss words and curse words. Somebody say amen. Yeah, he says, filthy language out of your mouth. He said, put these five sins off. Put these things off. They don't fit right on you anymore. Somebody say amen. I don't care if you say, man, I just do it. I'm old. I don't care if you say, oh, I'm young. I say what I want. Put it off. He says, put it off. It's not conducive to a child of God or your behavior. Matter of fact, he said, it can blow your witness to others. Somebody say amen. And so many people now are blowing their witness at work, on social media, in the community, by those five things he talked about. Somebody say amen. You don't realize you're blowing your witness with certain people. Hallelujah. I remember back in the day when I was younger, I was doing some stuff, and I went back to the club one time. I don't even feel right here, but I ran into somebody that knew me, I think from work or somewhere. Holy Spirit, you're blowing your witness. You're blowing your witness because you said you came from out of that same lifestyle. And that convicted me. Not that I'm perfect, anybody's perfect, but because of what I was presenting to others. Amen? Amen. So we have to realize we can be blowing our witness sometimes by what is coming out of our mouth, our actions, what we say and we do, where we frequent, where we go, can be blowing our witness. You say, well, I'm a believer in Christ, but your witness may not say that to others. Somebody say amen. Amen. It says here, but now you yourself are to put off all these anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy language out of your mouth. He said what? Put them off. Amen. Put them off. And make sure you never make fun of someone's disability. Always remember that. Sometimes people crack jokes or say stuff, or young people. Make sure you never say things that's injurious to people. Somebody say amen. Amen. Because really, he's saying here, those five things, more than likely they're coming out of our mouths. You know, because anger, that usually comes out too in rage. Amen. So that's why he says, set your mouths on things above. When you set your mouths on things above, then you can get your mouth to match your mind. Somebody say amen. You want your mouth to match your mind. Because what's coming out of your mouth is matching your mind. That's why the Bible said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. So whatever your mind is set on is coming out of your, come on somebody. The mouth does what the mind is set on. Come on. If you continually doing it, the mouth does what the mind is set on. Yeah. That's why when they said people be listening to certain type of music, of course, you keep listening to it over and over and over and over again, over again, over again. Yeah, you start saying the same thing that they saying because your mind got set on it. Somebody say amen. Yeah, the body does what the mind is set on. The hands does what the mind is set on. The feet does what the mind is set on. The sexual organs does what the mind is set on. That's why the Bible said, train yourself to be godly. Somebody said, we got to learn to discipline ourselves as believers. Give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise right now. That you saying to yourself, Lord, I need you to discipline me, work on me, train me, get me to where I need to be in Christ. Somebody say amen. Then look at verse 9. Verse 9 says, do not lie to one another. Somebody say, don't lie to one another. Since you have put off the old man with his deeds. It says, stop lying to one another. Lying here is to speak deliberate falsehood. It's deception. Somebody say deception. Lying can disrupt relationships. It can ruin trust. It can destroy your credibility. it's like it here to like deceitful speech. Matter of fact, if you look at Proverbs 6, 16, 17, 18, the seven things it said is abomination to the Lord and six things that he hate. You don't see sexual sins in there, but you do see a proud look and a lying tongue. A proud look and a lying tongue. The Bible says six things the Lord hate. Yes, some seven are an abomination to him. A proud look and a lying tongue. That's in Proverbs 6 and 16. And hands that shed innocent blood, and it goes on from there. So that's how God feels about lying, because lying can hurt people. It can injure people. It can destroy people, and it can kill people. You guys remember back in the day, the young man who got killed, African-American, remember Emmett Till? How did he die? Somebody lied on him. You see what I'm saying? Falsely accused, lying. So now we see how harsh lying can be. And the Bible said when we lie, the Bible says the devil is the father of lies. You know how sin came into the world? The devil lied directly to Eve's face. You will not surely die. But God just told you will. Did it by what? Lying. It says, do not lie to one another since you have put off the old man with his what? Deeds. Somebody said the old man is dead. That means he said you put off. That means, remember, the old man put off means to take off like soiled clothes. Take that thing off that's contaminating the new you and put on what? The new clothes. I remember, I think a while back, I shared this several times, how when I used to work in the oil refineries back in the day when I got out the military, and how when I came home, we was living in an apartment. When I came home, I would take off my jumpsuit and boots at the door because I didn't want to contaminate the house where I walk in or the clothes to touch anything because they was heavily soiled. So when he's saying put off, it's the same analogy. You got to put off that stuff that's soiling you, the new man. Somebody say amen. You're trying to walk in the new man with old clothes. Somebody say amen. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise. Say you got to put off the old so the new can come forth. Look at verse 10, the last verse here. Look at this. And says, and have put on the new man. Somebody say the new man. Who is renewed in the knowledge according to the image of him who created him. He said, and have put on the new man. Put on the new man. Put on the new man is like putting on new clothes. You take a shower, you get out, you put on what? New clothes, because you don't want to contaminate your body with the old soil clothes you just put off. See, the old man, it's the corrupt man. Somebody say amen. The old man is the lustful man. The old man is the old sinful man. The old man is the selfish man. The old man is the worldless, hopeless man. And he said, look, don't put on the old man anymore. You got to take off the old man and put on the new man. Somebody say amen. If you're a new creation in Christ, then you got resurrection power down inside of you. Somebody say amen. The new man is the new creation in Christ. We don't walk in the old man anymore. Somebody say put on the new man. The new man is the renewed man. The new man is the reborn man. The new man is the revived man. The new man is the resurrection man. Somebody give the Lord the praise on this morning and said, if you're going to put on the new man. See, the new man was raised to love like Christ, to live like Christ, to behave like Christ, to serve like Christ, to heal like Christ, to have compassion like Christ. That's the new man that we put on. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise that we ought to put on the new man. The new man forgives. The new man has power. The new man rises up. The new man resurrects like Christ. Somebody say, put on the new man, baby. You got to put on the new man. The new man is called by God. The new man is purposed by God. The new man is seated in heavenly places. The new man rises up every day. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise and say, we got to put on the new man, baby. The new man. Somebody say, put on the new man. You got to put on the new man. The new man has faith like Christ. Somebody said faith like Christ. The new man speaks the word of God like Christ. The new man trusts in God like Christ. The new man witnesses to the world like Christ. Somebody said you got to put on the new man, baby. You got to put on the new man. The new man was created in God's image. The new man was created to have dominion like God. The new man was created to have power like Christ. Somebody said put on the new man. If I could get two or three people this morning and said I'm taking off the
old man and I'm putting on the new man. The new man is who God created me to be. The new man God created me to be like God, to have morals like God, to have intellectual like God, to speak things in existence like God, to have the mindset of God. That is the new man in Christ. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise that we got to put on the new man. The new man is forgiven. The new man is predestined. The new man is blessed, baby. The new man is favored. Anybody here favored this morning? That's you, baby, the new man. The new man is protected. The new man is holy. The new man is righteous. The new man has an inheritance. The new man is saved. The new man has the abundant life. The new man has the eternal life. Somebody give God the glory right now that I'm going to put on the new man. I'm not worried about status. I'm not worried about a platform. I'm worried about being the new man in Christ, baby, and doing what God has called me to do. Somebody give God the glory on this morning and shout right now if you decided that you're going to put on the new man. He says the new man, put on the new man who is renewed in the knowledge according to the image of God. The new man is renewed. The new man is revived. And the new man is resurrected. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise for the new man. The new man speaks life. The new man focuses on God's goodness. The new man has God's grace in his life. Somebody said, I'm trying to operate in the new man. In the new man. We got to put off the old soil clothes, baby. And we got to walk in the new man. Somebody said, put it off, and put on the new man that was created in the image and likeness of Christ. You are a new creation in Christ. Put on the new man. That's what we got to do. The new man was created to be like Christ. That's why he said, kill these five things and put off these five things. And you need to put on the new man, the resurrected man that you are. And we talk about the new person in Christ, not male or female, the new creation. Who God created you to be in Christ after the resurrection. What are we going to do with his resurrection power that he has given us? The resurrection power he has given us have given us the power to overcome sin, has given us the power to walk in victory, has given us the power to overcome everything that we come up against. Put on the new man. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise on this morning. That we are to put on the new man. The new man is what God wants us to wear each and every day. We're not perfect, but we got to make up in our minds that we got to kill certain things in the flesh and that we have to put on the new man who is renewed in the knowledge according to the image of him who created him. The new man is created to be like God. So he said, I want all of us to act like it, walk like it, talk like it. Be like me. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. You have the power. I don't care what you're struggling with or what you're dealing with. You have the power to overcome it. He says, put to death your members which are on the earth. Right now, I want you to just lift your hands right now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Spirit of the living God, for those that are in this place on today, Lord, I pray right now, Lord, that we will put to death the members, Lord, that are pulling us outside of your will. Any sin or struggle or anything that's in our lives, Lord, that's contrary to your word, Lord, I pray that it will be put to death right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We know that Jesus was manifested to destroy the works of the flesh. Whatever work that the devil is trying to work against us, I decree and declare right now that it will not work in the mighty name of Jesus. That we will not give in to the vices and the fleshly desires of the world that's designed to lead us to destruction. But Father God, I pray right now that the resurrection power down in each inside of us, that we would take an evaluation of our lives and work on any area of our lives that's outside of your will. Lord, I thank you right now for salvation. I thank you for strengthening us, empowering us
to live the new life in Christ, to walk in the newness of life, and that we should put on the new man each and every day that was created in the image of God. Lord, mold each and every one of us into being the men and women of God that you have called us to be in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Whatever is not like you, kill it in our flesh, oh God. Whatever our flesh wants to hold on to that's outside of your word, kill it right now. Kill it right now, Lord. Give us the mind of Christ, Lord. May our minds be set on the things above and not the things on the earth, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Whatever is not like you, oh God, sweep through our memories right now, Father God. Uproot it, Lord, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, may we be led by the Holy Spirit each and every day to carry out the assignment for which you have purposed us to. Lord, we thank you right now for transformation in our lives, that we're setting our minds on things above, that we're putting to death things that are in our members that are outside of your will, oh God. And we're putting off things, Lord, that can hurt and injure others in the mighty name of Jesus. And we're declaring on today that we shall put on the new man that was created in your image to be like Christ. We give you the praise, the honor, and the glory. And we thank you, Lord, for what has transpired on today, Lord. May your power, Father God, dwell within us, Lord. We thank you for breakthrough. We thank you for deliverance. We thank you for healing. We thank you for doing it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise. It won't work. Hallelujah. It won't work. Hallelujah. It won't work. Hallelujah. It won't work.
It won't work.
It won't work.
It won't work.
Try to attack my mind.
It won't work.
Try to attack my life, but
it won't work. It won't work.
Try to attack our thoughts,
but it won't work.
Try to attack our family.
It won't work.
Try to attack our lives.
It won't work. It won't work.
Try to attack our children, but
it won't work.
Work, Lord, we thank you.
It won't work. It won't work. It won't work.
It won't work. It won't work. Right now, under the sound of my voice, if there is anyone here this morning who has not accepted Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior, today is your day. I want you to know on this morning that God loves you and he has a perfect plan for your life, that he sent his son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for your sins. The Bible says that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through him. Jesus is the only way. If you're here this morning, if you're watching online, if you want to make Jesus Christ your personal Lord and Savior, you can give your life to him on today. If you're unsure about your eternal destination, if you're saying, Pastor, I don't know if I leave this earth and die, I don't know where I would go. If you're unsure whether you would go to heaven or not, you can give your life to Christ on today. Right now, under the sound of my voice, if anyone here on today that wants to give their life to Jesus Christ, you're saying, Pastor, I want to be saved. I want eternal life. You want eternal life. You want to be saved. Hallelujah. You can raise your hand right now. Anybody here today, just lift your hands high so I can see it. Just lift it high. Anybody here today? Anybody here today? You want to give your life to Jesus? That's the most important decision you will ever make in your life, whether you give your life to the Lord or not. Hallelujah. If there's anyone that's watching online right now and you desire to give your life to the Lord, I want you to do this with me. I want you to pray this prayer with me right now. You can stretch your hand towards the altar right now and pray this prayer with me. Say, Father God, in Jesus' name, I know that I'm a sinner and I'm in need of a Savior. I believe your son, Jesus Christ, died on the cross for my sins. From this day forward, I surrender my life to you. I repent right now of all of my sins. Thank you, Lord, for saving me. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise. If you're watching online and you prayed that prayer,
know that you are a born again believer. Hallelujah. And that you have eternal life now. Now, if you prayed that prayer, make sure you get connected to a Bible believing church so you can grow your faith in the Lord. Hallelujah. God has a perfect plan for your life and he loves you. But if you prayed that prayer sincerely in your heart, know that you're saved now. You're a born again believer. Get connected to a Bible believing church so you can grow your faith in the Lord. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. If you're in the local area, please come by and visit us. We would love to have you in our presence here at Destiny Church. Amen. Amen. We certainly thank God for each and every one of you on today. We're now going to transition to our celebration in giving. How many know God loves a cheerful giver? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank God for all of your faithful giving on today. We want to make it a point in 2024 to be faithful in our giving. Amen. We want to be faithful in our giving. We want to set our minds on things above. And that means also giving back to the Lord what belongs to him. The Bible said God owns the cattle on a thousand hills. Whatever income God has given us that we have, it is a blessing that comes from God. And we give back to him through tithes and offering what belongs to him. Giving is an act of worship. Hallelujah. And we should be excited and ecstatic to be able to give back to God how he has blessed us. If anybody needs a tithe and offering envelope, you can raise your hand. Just raise it high. If you're watching online, you can give by going to our Cash App, the money sign, Destiny Church Live to give, or our secure website too as well. Amen. But God bless each and every one of you. Anybody need a tithe and offering envelope? Amen. We're ready to give. Come on. Lift your hands before the Lord. Let's pray over these gifts right now. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you and we praise you for what has transpired on today. And we lift these tithes and offering up before you right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we pray right now that they would be used for your glory. Lord, we pray that you would bless this church, bless our community, bless the kingdom of God abroad. I pray right now, Lord, that you will open up the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing we won't have room enough to receive. Lord, we thank you right now, Lord, for blessing us to be able to give back to you during this time of worship. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. You're now into the hands of our ushers at this time. Hallelujah. You can also give by going to our Cash App. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus' name. Somebody said, put on the new man. Amen. Put on the new man who's renewed in the knowledge of God. Amen. We got to put on the new man each and every day. We got to put to death certain members in our bodies and put off certain things so we can walk in the new man that God has created us to be. Amen. Also be mindful we're going to be having our time of corporate prayer and fasting on next week, midweek on April 24th on Wednesday. So be mindful that you can put that down. So April 24th, we're going to have our time of corporate prayer and fasting on April 24th. That would be on not this Wednesday, but the following week, our time for corporate prayer. Amen. We always fast going into the new month. Amen. All these months are going by so fast already. It's already April, and April is already moving quickly. So we want to pray during the month of April, our time of corporate prayer and fasting. The Bible says these kind go out only by what? Prayer and fasting. So I look forward to all of us connecting on next week. Amen. For our time of corporate prayer and fasting. Amen. Remember, you know, during the week when you get this word on Sunday morning, make sure you take that word. Get to yourself or your family. Amen. You got family? Dissect that word together. It's enough for you to go over the whole week for Bible study. Amen. So take the word of God that you get on Sunday morning and take it back with yourself and your family and dissect it and say, how does this apply to my life? Amen. How can this build my life? When God gives the word out on Sunday, that prophetic word, He gives it out so the people can go back and dissect it of how it applies to your life and how it can build your life. Amen?
Amen. So take that word back and study it during the week. Empower yourself, your family, and go out and be a witness and empower others. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Let's go ahead and stand to our feet to be dismissed. Hallelujah. But we certainly thank God, praying for peace, God's favor, God's love to be upon each and every one of you on today. God bless you all. We thank God for you on this Sunday morning. Hallelujah. Let's go ahead and pray out right now. Amen. To be dismissed in the house of the Lord. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for what transpired here on today. We thank you, Lord, for the dynamic praise and worship and the preach word. Lord, we thank you for teaching us all things on today to put on the new man that was created in Christ, Lord. So until we meet again, oh God, may your grace, your favor, your love forever surround us. Continue to bless our going out and bless our coming in. May the blood of Jesus be upon each and every one of us. And may we all have a blessed, phenomenal week in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you all. Hallelujah. Enjoy the rest. Ooh.